Hi, this is Ethan with BIMsmith. Today's video is going to be looking at shared nested families and how they can help save time and make workflows a little bit simpler and easier when you're using families that are almost always put together or assembled together. So in this case, we're going to look at assembling an ADA water closet along with all the other necessary parts of that into a single family, then load it up into our project. So the advantage here of using a shared nested family is that the shared nested family schedules as if it was placed just as is within the project from the get-go. So for the purposes of this example, we're going to have a grab bar, we're going to have a toilet paper dispenser, we're going to have a sanitary napkin receptacle, we're going to have the water closet itself. And those are all going to go into a single family. The advantage here is that that family can be mirrored or flipped around, rotated, things like that, into whatever kind of configuration we need, with all these things staying in the same relationship to one another. So in order to kind of get started, we're just going to go ahead and share all the families. So the shared parameter is over here in the properties panel, and each one of these families is going to have it. So we're going to go ahead and share all of them, because we want them to schedule in the project once we get there. And then once that's done, I'm going to go ahead and drag my my family back in. So this is going to be the actual host for all of these families. They're going to go ahead and live in here. I'm going to do a couple things here with my lines or with my reference planes. So I'm going to go ahead and bring them in like this. So this is still going to be my origin point. I still want to place it in the corner, but I'm going to rename these a little bit just so that they're a little bit easier. So this is going to go to back. We're going to rename it here too. So it's just going to say back. Go ahead and pin that, and then this is going to say side, just because I don't know if it's going to be the left or the right. And then we're just going to make it a strong reference plane and it defines the origin. All right, so we got the back wall, we got the side wall, and now we're going to go ahead and load our families in. So let's start with the water closet, because everything else is going to be kind of in relation to it. So we're going to load it into family number one. It's a face-based family. It knows that you're probably going to want to place it on a vertical face, so it's automatically sensing this reference plane and giving me some options. So I'm gonna go ahead and drop it on this reference plane. And then we're gonna start constraining it. So I'm sure as most of you are aware, there's pretty strict rules as to where you put these kinds of things. So for the purposes of this demonstration, I'm just gonna go ahead and assume it's gonna be 18 inches from the wall. And we're gonna go ahead and lock that just so it doesn't move around on us throughout the process. Obviously, if you were trying to create something a little bit more customizable, let's say you find yourself frequently in a position where you're kind of tweaking that between 17 and 19 inches, which I think is the allowable range per code, you can create that as a parameter, right? You could actually create a label for that, make it a parameter. But just for this, we're not gonna go there. So that is the toilet. Toilet's been added and it's shared. So we're just gonna close that out. Next up, I'm going to go ahead and do this grab bar. We're going to do three grab bars. We're going to do the two horizontal and the vertical. So I'm going to go ahead and place all those, load it into the family. Same situation. So it's placing on a vertical face. We're going to just go ahead and throw one in over here, throw one in over there. And then I'm going to put another one on here and we'll rotate it from the other, from the elevation. So let's go ahead and do the back bar. Okay, so those are, yeah, we can also do the toilet elevation while we're here. So toilet elevation for this guy looks like he may be low, or maybe the handrails are high. A bit of both. Okay, so we're looking at this toilet. We're going to want that to be up around 18 inches, I believe. Doing this from memory, guys, so don't judge me. So yeah, we're going to go ahead and make that 18 inches. Grab bar elevation for the two horizontals is between 33 and 36. I'm going to go ahead and just put them at 3 feet. That's 36 inches. Now we need to make sure that they're in the correct position. So I'm going to find my applicable points. Those reference planes, just like how the code dimensions everything. So we're going to make this rear grab bar a new type. So I'm going to duplicate it. We're going to say 36 inches. This is going to become 36 inches, 3 feet. And then this distance is supposed to be 12-inch minimum from the center line of the toilet. So I'm actually going to move this witness line back to my toilet. Click on this and put this in at 12 inches. So then the other side is 2 feet because it's a 3-foot bar. And then I see here I got my other one in section. I'm just going to go ahead and drag that down. And then this is probably my one that's supposed to flip around and be my vertical bar. Okay, now that I've got these kind of loaded in, I'm going to go ahead and close this. Locks that dimension, lock that dimension. And then we're going to go ahead and look at this thing from the right. Let's do this from the left, I guess. Okay, so then on this side, you see I've got, this is going to be my vertical bar, this is going to be my horizontal bar. The horizontal bar is another 12 inches from the back, so set that to 1 foot, lock that dimension, and then it is a 42-inch minimum. So we're going to duplicate this type, we're going to say 42-inch, 3'6". Okay, and then that's there. And the grab bar is supposed to be 40 inches off the back wall, the vertical grab bar. So that's 40 inches off the back wall. It's typically 18 inches tall. So we're gonna go ahead and duplicate this as well, just so we have a discrete type for each of these. This goes to 18 inches. Looks like that's not available in this particular manufacturer's products, but we're just going to go ahead and click through that. And then measure the height off the floor. So I think this is supposed to be between 39 and 40 inches, 41 inches. So we're going to go ahead and type in 40 inches and let that slide up a little bit. And then we're going to go ahead and lock these dimensions as well. So that gets locked in place. That's locked. Toilet, everything else. Okay, so now we need to add the toilet paper dispenser. So we're going to pull this in. Make sure it's getting placed on the right work plane. So it automatically switches me back to plan view, which is very convenient. So I'm going to go ahead and make sure that's placed on there. You guys can see here that the course view for this family is sort of this block. Not super helpful. I'm going to turn it on medium so I can at least, you know, still see my reference lines or my reference planes, things like that. So we know that's going to go end up somewhere like there. And then this is the sanitary napkin. So it's going to go in as well. We'll place it on the reference plane here, just like that. And then I'm going to go ahead and just close out of these just so we can get this back up. Okay. So back to my elevation real quick. You can kind of tell things have been placed all over the place. So get that right side up. Go to 3D view, see if this is the right way or not. Don't think so. I think that's upside down too. Okay. So now we've got those two, and we need to go ahead and place those in the right spots and lock them into place. So back to my elevation. The toilet paper dispenser is supposed to be a 42-inch max from the wall. Seems a little bit far. And do note, guys, like some of these requirements differ state to state, you know, municipality to municipality. Some are, you know, based off of the IBC, which has slightly different requirements than ADA. And then obviously, if you're in an international situation, that's a whole different thing as well. So I'm just going to go ahead and say that the requirements for that toilet paper dispenser is at 7 to 9 inches off the nose of the toilet, according to ADA. So we're going to go ahead and make that 9 inches, which puts us into the right ballpark for both. Make sure I get that locked because we want to keep that in place. Then the sanitary napkin is typically a little bit behind that, looking at something here that just says line it up with the nose of the toilet. So we're going to go ahead and do that too. And then in terms of elevation, I think it's a minimum of 18 inches to the bottom of that. I'm not getting a great reference plane here to place that to, so we're just going to kind of pick one. And then we'll drop that down to 18 inches. Same thing with the napkin. Want to just make sure that's the right reference plane. And then we can drop him down. So, nope, I don't think I got him. There we go. That should do it. So this needs to be 18 inches as well. So that's a little, maybe too lined up. But it'll do for now. So yeah, for the purposes of what we've been doing, this is all now placed and locked and should be ready to go. So let's go ahead and save it. So I'm going to do a quick save as. And we're just going to call it ADAWC. Oh, I already named something that. Okay, well, we're just going to write it over it and then create a new... a new project. So this new project, I'm going to do the Imperial Architectural. And then we're just going to create some generic walls to make a corner. Probably way too big, but still, we'll go ahead and load this into that project from here. And you can see that all this stuff has come in all together. And obviously, this is sort of useful for a single project, but as you start doing ADA bathrooms over and over and over again. It's nice to have sort of each of these, you know, these families that you can just keep reusing. You can also set them up to be customizable. You could probably even put a sink in here and a mirror. So it's a full single user bathroom. If that was something that, you know, your firm does all the time, that could be helpful to do. But this can just be a huge time saving. So I'm going to create a new schedule, specialty equipment. Unfortunately, it's all these washrooms accessories are probably going to end up being specialty equipment. So drop in family and type and count, description. Let's see, manufacturer, you know, throw a couple of the other good ones in there. That should do for now. So you can see here that I've quickly got the schedule of all of those shared nested pieces. So that's huge. That's very, very helpful. I was able to pull that all together very, very quickly. So another thing, and just kind of keep drilling down into the options here, I won't get too carried away with all the things you can do here, but you could easily tie the visibility, say for the sanitary napkin dispenser, to a visibility parameter here that says something like, you know, make that an instance parameter. So if it's a men's versus a women's, we can put something in here like napkin visibility. Okay. Okay, drop that into the project, overwrite, and then, you know, when I come in here, turn off that napkin. It won't show up in plan or elevation, and it's off my schedule. All right, so that was a pretty quick introduction to the idea of shared nested families and what they can be used for. Obviously, this is just sort of one use case. Another use case would be putting doors and door hardware in the same family. So that way you can sort of switch things out. Another really powerful tool here is that if you use a couple different kinds of products, you could apply a parameter that would allow you to change the nested families out. But that's probably a topic we'll tackle in a subsequent video. Thanks for watching.